Well, hello there, Bob McCown here. This is, okay, you got 5 minutes, and that's exactly what you've got. We'll bring somebody on, they'll ask me a few questions, we'll chit-chat for a bit, and then away you go. Carry on. Continue your day, your evening, your morning, whatever part of the 24-hour period you're dealing with right now. We'll get to it in just 30 seconds after this.
Does it diminish your super capacity to love? Does it diminish your super capacity to love? Walk
like... We're back. This is OK. You got 5 minutes. I'm McCown. This is over here on the other side of the screen is Clint from Airdrie, Alberta. Where's Airdrie? No idea.
It's just north of Calgary.
Just north of Calgary. Yep. I see you've got a Browns jersey on. 73. Why 73?
It's Joe Thomas, my favorite player.
Joe Thomas, now retired, yes?
Yeah, unfortunately, but...
You see, this is what you need to go with that. You need an autographed Jim Brown, Cleveland Browns helmet right there. There it is.
That would work.
Yeah, but you got to have the 32 number. I got one upstairs in the other room, but I'm not going to go get it for you. All right, you got 5 minutes. What do you want?
Okay, all this talk about the greatest of all time in basketball after The Last Dance came out. Who's the greatest of all time in hockey? Give me the player, give me the goaltender.
The player's Bobby Orr. But, I mean, you have to put Gretzky, like, really close. I've said this before, I'll keep it brief. I got a chance to watch Bobby Orr at the peak of his career. I also had the opportunity, I was actually at Maple Leaf Gardens when the Bruins were in town one Saturday morning and they had a skate, and I saw Bobby Orr make a play that baffled me completely. And he was the kind of guy who would never do that in a game because he wouldn't want to show the other team up. He really was that kind of person. And so I give Bobby Orr the edge. Gretzky, very close second. And then after that, you know, you've got Howe, you've got Lemieux, you've got a bunch of guys that you certainly have to consider. Best goaltender of all time. That is harder for me. Wow. Patrick, maybe. He'd be near the top there. Brodeur would be near the top.
Mm-hmm.
I'm trying to go back. You know, Glenn Hall, 500 and what was it? 112, 500 and something consecutive games is ridiculous. But that's a record he holds. And yet he played in an era with six teams in the NHL, and I think all the goaltenders were great. Glenn Hall, Jacques Plante, Johnny Bauer. I mean, you could go down the list. Almost every team had a great goaltender. Okay. But there's a couple anyway. Something else.
Back to the first question. I'm trying to understand what Bobby Orr was like. Like, I've seen videos of him and everything, but I can't really, like, he played before I was born, so I can't really relate to how good he was. I'm picturing Connor McDavid playing defense. Is that a fair kind of comparison? Like, that kind of speed, that kind of just thinking?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's not bad. Bobby Orr he might have been the most unselfish player I've ever seen. And he reminded me in many ways of, we were talking about, you mentioned Jordan. You know, Jordan is a basketball player. I always felt Michael Jordan could have scored 60, 70, 80 points in every game if he wanted to.
Yep.
But he shared the basketball. He wasn't he wasn't a selfish player. He shared the ball. He took command when he needed to. Mm. And if the Bulls were down in the fourth quarter, he'd say, okay, that's enough of you four guys. Look, just give me the ball. And he'd score 25 in the fourth quarter and win the game. And Orr was kind of a similar player. He was extraordinarily unselfish, a complete gentleman, although he'd beat the crap out of you if you fooled around with him.
Yeah.
So, you know, he had that instinct still in him, that, you know, that core instinct. But he if you ever get a chance to watch any video of Bobby Orr play, almost at any time in his career, and you know the last few years he played on two really bad legs. He had, I don't know how many knee surgeries, 6, 8 on one knee alone. He was just something special to watch.
Cool. Second question, who's your favorite interview that you ever did when you were on primetime?
So I've answered this question before, I know, but there's really three guys. Muhammad Ali would be probably, I don't know who's at the top of the list, but Ali used to call my show occasionally. I was with him in the Bahamas for his last fight against Trevor Burbick, and we became pretty good friends. Jim Brown, the great Cleveland Browns running back, was the first player that I really idolized, and I think was the greatest football player I've ever seen. Retired at age 29 in the middle of his career. And Jim Brown came in studio with me one morning. He was in Toronto and joined me in studio. We spent an hour chatting. Afterwards, you know, as he was on his way out the door, I said, well, what else you got going on today? And he says, well, I'm in town until tonight. I got a flight. I don't know where it was, back to LA or back to Cleveland. And so I invited him to go play golf. And so I got a chance to spend the whole day with him, like Jim Brown and I on a golf cart, just the two of us. And the third guy on the list would have to be Coach Paul Bear Bryant of the University of Alabama. And, you know, I grew up in, you know, I'm a native of Columbus, Ohio, so I'm a Buckeye fan. But, and we hated Alabama. But Coach Bryant was so revered as so legendary that the chance to sit down with him, which I did, I went to Tuscaloosa, Alabama, mm-hmm. and spent, I want to say, about 40 minutes interviewing him. We were supposed to do 5 minutes, and the coach just let me keep talking, so I did. And that was one of the more enjoyable interviews that I did. And then just a few months later, he passed away, quite surprisingly. And it happened that my interview with him was the last one he did in his life. Wow. And that interview was aired by Ted Koppel on Nightline. Those are the three that kind of stand out, and three that probably can't be, well, other than Jim Brown, the other two have passed away, so can't be repeated. And I'll remember those the rest of my life. Your time has concluded, unfortunately. I love the uniform. The Brown cap doesn't have a logo on it, but then again, the Browns don't have a logo, so you couldn't put one on there anyway, could you?
No, you couldn't.
And this is what you need to get. Don't forget the Jim Brown helmet to go with all that, all right?
Okay, got it.
Good job, Clint. Thanks, pal. We'll see you again, I hope.
Okay, thanks for having me.
Bye-bye. That's Clint in Airdrie, Alberta. We'll have more next time. This is okay. You got 5 minutes.
Today's the day. You can call me names, point fingers, tell me exactly what an a-hole I actually am.
Hey, McCown here. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and you can watch previous episodes of OK, You Got 5 Minutes.